Well, first of all, you need to loosen up that belt, let them jeans down.
Pull them down.
Don't pull them down like you're gonna go.
Like a hoe.
No.
Like a that.
Yeah.
But don't show your huggies though, man.
No, this is my auntie pants.
What kind of music you listen to?
I like very much a Corky Butchek. You know Corky Butchek? Bing bang, bing bang, bing ding 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 ding. Bing bang, bing bang, bing ding 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 ding. Can you teach me speak like you?
What are you trying to say?
How you say? How do you do?
What's up with it?
What's that with it?
I don't see how you can even walk out of here with that baby in your hands without someone stopping you and taking that baby out of your possession.
All right, well, there is a finale to this talk show. Please welcome Shatanya Megans from the State Child Services Department.
Oh,
what would be the opinion of the legal opinion of the state, which is empowered to look after, children and their welfare?
This child is.
I've got some business idea that I just want to tell you about, and I'll be a fool if very quick. What is the most popular thing in the world? Music. No. Tell me. Ice cream. Everyone has it. And what is the problem with ice cream? It drips. So my idea is what?
To make it drip with ice cream.
No. Good idea. Alright, whatever. You ain't gonna come out with that. My idea is to come out with just like these ice cream gloves that make the ice cream not go on your hands and make it all well sticky. And also keep your hands warm when you is eating the ice cream. Is you win or is you win?
It sounds like a good idea. I hope you make a lot of money. Good luck, folks. It's been nice seeing you. You take care of yourself.
Okay, is he going to be in on that?
Well, it sounds like an interesting.
He's got that key that he's going to be in it.
Good. The last episode of the show is with O.J. Simpson, and you play a character that's an Italian billionaire. Is that who O.J. thought he was being interviewed by?
Yes. It was secretly filmed, and was in a hotel room in Vegas. And the last time O.J. was in a hotel room in Vegas, he ended up in jail. Obviously.
Yes, he did. He ended up in prison for like 11 years.
Yep. So the aim was to... I was trying to get him to confess to the... alleged murders.
Right.
Wow.
Which was ambitious.
Yes,
it was ambitious. So I actually trained a little bit with one of the top FBI interrogators.
Really?
Not very successfully because I didn't get OJ to confess.
What's up, man? Good morning.
Sparked our slab outside. We're looking for somewhere to post up our black asses for the night.
Wow.
So bang bang a skid skid, nigga.
Bro, I used to watch Ali G, and I didn't never know how fucking racist this shit was. This shit was racist as fuck. It was so stereotypical. Oh my. I used to laugh at this shit as a kid.
Right, we have a picture of you both here. There you are there. How did that no, ice cream. And I go, what is the problem with ice cream? He goes, it melts. I go, so what is my invention? He goes, non-melting ice cream. I go, that is actually a wicked idea. That's not fair to mind. It better not than that idea. I go, no, it's the ice cream glove. Anyway, he did not invest and decided to move into politics instead.
But didn't he walk out of the interview? Is that right? He said, no, he
claims that he did. He claims that he saw through the interview, but actually he was there for about 7 minutes.
Right.
Yeah.
Is that long for an IG interview?
Yeah.
But he was very jolly through the whole interview. I mean,
well, they often are. If you get rid of the ex-wife,
you get right. Yeah. Yeah.
I was representing a Omani sheikh, and the Omani sheikh would pay O.J. Simpson to confess to the murders. He'd pay him $2 million because he wanted to kill his own wife. He saw O.J. as like, you know, he absolutely loves you. You want to kill his own wife. You are the greatest wife stealer. And he kept on saying, no, he said, no, I didn't kill my wife. You know, I go, yeah, I didn't kill my wife either. She just got so depressed. She put herself in the body bag. She filled it with rocks. And she pushed herself over the yard. That's right.
And OJ laughed and laughed.
Yeah, he laughed and laughed. So he said, like, this sheikh wants to, I go, well, he wants to, you know, make a laugh with a hook while you are in the room telling him how you did. And he said, listen, I got no problem being in the room with the sheikh while he's, you know, making love with a hooker.
Yeah.
Because I didn't do it.
But the rest, yeah.
This child is here illegally.
No, it's not. I made a deal with the mother.
And at this time, we're taking the child into protective custody.
So we see how the so-called Negro, the so-called black culture, is denigrated, yet assimilated, cultivated, and then monetized by the powers that be, or should I say, the families that be. We see how nothing has really changed from the plantation. It's the same game, the same players,
and
the same tactics. I recently shared this post. In no wise speak against the truth, but be abashed of the error of white ignorance. Now, I grew up watching Ali G, finding Ali G funny, and being a fan of Ali G. Now, as I've woken up to the truth, and I know the game players, and I know the tactics, I'm quite abashed for the error of my ignorance. I mean, even in this image, we can see how Borat is saying it's from Kazakhstan. And when you research Kazakhstan, you'll realize that it was a Mongol dynasty that was then annexed by the Russian Empire. So it became one and the same with Russia. Now check out this following quote. Russia contains 1/4 of the inhabitants of all Europe and 1/2 of the entire number of Israelites. Isaac Meir Weiss, American rabbi, born in Moravia, Austrian Empire. Now we know that he's talking about the European Japhetic imposters.
What's up, sir?
Who left Europe, came to America, set up plantations, auctioned.
Yep, I'm about to go to work in like 30 minutes. I got on earlier, like probably 20 minutes ago. I'm just waiting for my wife, that's why. Bro, I went live last night, and I don't know what language these people are in my chat room. if you could, if you could go to my live that I did last night and tell me if you know what that language is. Yeah, it was like damn near hieroglyphic. Like Kazakhstan or some shit. Nah, it wasn't Arabic. I know Arabic. It was a trip. Russian, huh?
Depends. Well, I'm not sure if it'd be that into Rebel Wilson, but she's hilarious in that.
Yeah.
What about Bruno? Bruno would think, oh, Nabi is so hot. Oh my god, I was looking at it completely upset.
Hopefully, you have seen how images and ideas of others by the media have colonized the minds of the people to fulfill their role and somebody else's.
Shout out to Russia.
The Almighty commands us to bring that down to the street. May you live to see the accidental dominance of the white race over front. Cool.
We don't believe in. Oh my god.
We believe that at the sound of a trumpet they will come to.
Tommy Sotomayor just dunked on the whole team. They should leave Kobe the fuck alone. No. Just leave Jerry West punk ass on there.
Gee, that's too bad.
Cause Kobe wouldn't want to even be on the logo. He cocky, he ain't that damn cocky. I remember Ali G. I really used to watch that fucking show, bro. And this motherfucker is racist as fuck. I never really used to realize that when you. Yeah, dude, he really used to just come out and portray like the worst of the black person, of a black man. The way he would talk, like all that shit. Like I'm now looking at it, like damn, this shit crazy. That shit crazy. And remember Good Burger? That movie? Oh no, they used to just always. Yeah, Kenan and Kel, whatever the fuck. How they made what's her name so dumb? They made them dumb, bro. Yeah, but why are all the skits about black men? Either, never mind, you get what I'm saying. Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, and it is funny, when you young and you watching that shit, you don't catch the little hidden, what's the name? Yeah. And then you get older and be like, damn, I've been played this whole fucking... That shit kind of fucked up. Yeah, yeah. That was fucked up. Oh my God, bro. Facts. When I went back on, when you go back on all that shit kind of like, damn. And it was all ran by Jews. Yeah, but they were. Somebody paid them off. Yeah, somebody paid them off well. Fucking Wayne. Yeah, look, you laugh because you know somebody paid them off real well. Y'all gonna hear? Y'all gonna take this check? Go dress up like women. Y'all do it, whatever. They pushed every agenda. I ain't even talking about that. I'm talking about the actual living color, like. Right, they've been doing it though since A Living Color. That's what I'm telling you. They had skits where two dudes used to sit. Man, wow. Wow, bro. Wow. Definitely is all for the money. Before you go anywhere, don't forget to click to subscribe. Oh, damn. Damn. Oh, baby. Make them dance. Call a body.
Thoughts, camera, action. Presents.
After the game of football, I never really knew what I wanted to do afterwards. Nothing could really fill that void.
Nice. Look at you. Ooh. Brett. You mother. What up with you guys? Good morning. Yeah, I clickbaited Tommy Sotomayor's name. I had to. But at least I did really make him in the game, so he really is playing in the game. So I really didn't lie. You see NBA 2K right there. It's not a it's not really a, you know, clickbait. I am in 30 minutes. I am in 30 minutes. Oh, I was doing some. I'm testing some stuff out. That's why. I want to see why certain things was not happening when I was doing. Oh. No, Streamlabs. I'm a Streamlabs. Oh man, hold on. Oh, oh. This is an actual John Henry Clark, the boy who painted Christ black.
Of something or someone that makes you feel proud. Like Duval here. Stand up, Duval.
Now, over the next couple of weeks, your teachers will decide which of your efforts should be displayed at our Pride Day assembly next month. At that time, I will decide which one is the very best.
And I'll be here for that.
That's what it seemed like, huh?
So-called educated Negroes that think the white, the slave master's education is above common sense. Okay?
Actually, I think he does have long-ass arms. Fuck yeah.
My name is Leslie McNeil.
My name is Sam Crenshaw.
The name of my fraternity is the Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
And we do like this.
I do! I'm
Donna Lowry with Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated.
So we decided on that day that we would go no other way. We cracked.
Wow.
We may belong to different houses, but we're all a part of the same trusted family. We may belong to different houses, but we're all a part of the same trusted family.
Bet y'all are.
In those days, when thoughts of Israel, wicked men, who persuaded many, saying, let us go and make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us. But since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow. 1 Maccabees, chapter 1, verse 11. King James Version, 16.
All right,
Sigma Pi Phi, the Boule, the fraternity is extremely elite. 126 chapters, only 5,000 members, many with postgraduate degrees. Notable members include Martin Luther King, W.E.B. Du Bois, Vernon Jordan, Eric Holder, Thurgood Marshall, Messi, Jesse Jackson, Al Kanasagi, Under the Chin Face, Sharpton, Bill the Pill Cosby, and
you just woke up right now, you've been up.
This list consists of upper echelon black Greeks as well. Imagine a minor league for house niggas, if you will.
Oh, wow, he missed that?
He's fucking dirty, man. He's gonna be retarded. Any fraternity, being a legacy helps. This is the wealthiest group of black people on earth. A unified squad of uppity Negroes sworn and blackmailed into secrecy.
Oh shit. Damn.
Declaring getting better and better. Now I'd like to introduce shit. To you someone you don't see around here very often.
I found a way to run my old computers with no hard drive. Here it is. And it's not in this computer.
A new book is addressing the age-old question about whether people of African descent were present in biblical history. The Bible is Black History explores DNA evidence and the work of historians and scientists to prove that black people were part of the Israelite community.
In love with his own reflection that he drowned in the water. And that's where we get the phrase narcissistic, you know? So when it says men will be lovers of themselves, that's a very narcissistic trait. Yeah? And we're going to start breaking down this graven image.
Nice.
What is graven image worship? Because there seems to be a bit of confusion. And this is where I said, there's so many ways to go at unearthing this and breaking it down, you know? There's an element of, there's a thin line between truth and error. So we're going to try and look at this thing because I hear a lot of arguments that are very dogmatic, and then I hear arguments that are very liberal, you know? So hopefully what we're going to do is look at, and this... spake unto you in Horeb out of the midst of the fire, lest ye corrupt yourselves and make you a graven image, the similitude of any figure, the likeness of male or female, the likeness of any beast that is on the earth, the likeness of any winged fowl that flieth in the air, on the ground, the likeness of any fish that is in the waters beneath the earth. Unless thou lift up thine eyes unto heaven, and when thou seest the sun, and the moon, and the stars, all the host of heaven should be driven to worship them, and serve them, which the Lord thy God have divided unto all nations under the whole heaven. But the Lord have taken you, and brought you forth out of the iron furnace, even out of Egypt, to be unto him a people of inheritance, as ye are this day. So in the commandments it says don't worship any graven images, no, don't worship images. Actually, let me put the commandment in so we can see that too.
That's what they do. Bible study type thing, something light. I'm always seeking knowledge, bro. Go left. Badger right now.
I'm saying this for a reason, because the next slide I want you guys to interact with me. So now,
let's go left.
In the Egyptian community, cats were highly regarded to the extent where cats were almost deified. Well, not almost, they were deified, you know, the Sphinx and all these other strange items or animals.
Oh, bad shot.
Also, tombs and monuments of fallen
pharaohs. Wow, that's fucking crazy.
And people would pay homage to these graven images. Now, over to you guys. Over to you guys. Over to you guys. Let's see where you guys are at. Because there's going to be very different responses. So let's see what everyone's on. Okay, so which one of these is idolatry, if any? So which one of these is idolatry? We've just read, thou shalt not make any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above or the earth beneath or that is in the water under the
earth. Nice.
So I've got my little book here of the blue whale. That's something that's in the sea. I've got my little book here of birds, National Geographical. I got my book here of peekaboo. I got my history book here. I've got my human biology book that I need to learn about human biology.
Red. I
got my ABC chart.
Shit.
You know, that helps kids learn the ABCs. which one of these is idolatry? If any at all. Wow. Kind of, okay. Let's see what people are saying. Okay, I'm just reading the chat feeds to see what you guys are saying. Wow. Everyone's saying, oh, you know. Okay, Michael. Michael's saying none. Okay. Otai Africa Rice saying none of them. Okay. Tammy saying none. Boy, this is why we need to be of one accord, you know. This is why we need to be of one accord, you know. Because I'm probably gonna get booed. But okay. I have to ask these questions, these open questions, you know. Because like I said, there's the dogmatic crowd. And as the liberal crowd, the dogmatic crowd says, anything! Ah! Yeah? And the liberal crowd says, no! Damn. So then you got these two opposing views, yeah? So, for example, none, they're not graven, that's what Olutag says. A lot of people are saying they are, and a lot of people are saying none. This is why it's good to have perspective, it's good to have context. And it's good to have, it's just good to, you know what it is, the Bible says,
I should have waited.
The letter of the call, the letter of the Lord killeth me. Yeah, but with the spirit there is life. I might have misquoted that, so let me find that later on in the study. Let me try now while you guys are still answering that question. So many of us, we reference the law without the spirit behind the law. Now, this is not to minimize or trivialize the commandments, Yah forbid. But that's how many of us deal with issues. So, for example, on Sabbath now, you know, if your next door neighbor broke down in their car, some people
would
say, well, the Bible says you shouldn't go out and do this because it's the holy day of the Lord, which is, it's the holy day of Yahuwah. If your neighbor's broken down next to you, you're not gonna help the brother. Or if someone is in dire straits, you're not gonna help the brother. Or are you gonna say you're gonna show the letter of the law and of the spirit? Okay. So anyway, let me go through these
cards
and let me find out what you guys
good game,
think.
Good game, good game.
If there is any at all. Okay, so let's start with, what should we start with? Let's start with this alphabet thing. So if you came into my house now and you saw this on my wall, for one of my children to learn their alphabet, yeah? It's got A for apple, B for bee, C for a cat, and D for a dog, E for elephant, F for a frog. That's made up. But alright, if you saw that on the wall, would you throw me an uppercut and sprinkle some holy water on me and say, nah, That's idolatry, or would you say isn't idolatry?